Here we have a 68 plate Mercedes-Benz C220d Sport Premium. Now this vehicle comes with the 18 inch alloy wheels. We do also have the iridium silver metallic paintwork. We have the LED headlights, Panamerica front grille with the black Mercedes badge in the centre, and there's a look at that front end. Coming around to the passenger side now, you'll find the colour coded door handles and door mirrors. We also have the black brushed metal trim around the windows and the privacy glass for the rear passengers. Now we do also have the front and rear parking sensors on this vehicle with a reversing camera and a visual display inside. Coming around to the rear, you can see we have the C220d badging on the left, and there's a look at that rear end. Back around to the driver's side now, you can see the vehicle is free from any major marks, dents or scratches. So if we take a look then at the interior, inside of the back first you'll find the leather interior, got the full leather, the grey stitching, foldable armrests in the centre and the fixed ISO points as well back here. We got the electric windows on the doors along with the integrated speakers. Same leather interior at the front, with both front seats being electrically adjustable and heated. We have the electric mirrors, electric windows, we have the automatic light, multifunctional steering wheel. And if we just take a seat inside, then you'll find the digital dashboard in front of us. We have a nice little animation just there as we get in. If we put our foot on the brake, press the start button, the vehicle will start up for us. We've got the paddle shifters either side of the steering wheel. Let's turn the volume down just there. Cruise control and speedometer as well on the right hand side. And we are free from any warning lights on the digital dashboard other than about the fuel level, so nothing to worry about. We can go through different features on here, so if we go onto the main menu, we can scroll through all these different options just here. And we can also change the style design, so it's currently on classic, go to sport, see it change like so. We also have the main screen here in the centre, which is currently showing the sat nav. If it is flickering or if any lights are flickering, it's just the camera, they're not flickering in real life, so nothing to worry about. We've got the sat nav there, but we do have the shortcuts down here, so click onto radio, you find the radio stations will appear. We also have the media options where you find the Bluetooth audio and a few other sources just there as well. We have the Bluetooth phone connectivity for making phone calls. And if you go onto the main menu, we can scroll through the other features. So if we go across to connect, then you'll find that we have the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Moving further down, we have the vents just here. We also have the dual zone climate control for the front passengers with the R-Score air conditioning. Nice gloss black trim here in the center. Again, we've got the buttons for the screen. We then also have some storage inside of here. Two cup holders, we have a USB port, and then also the wireless phone charging as well. Then we have the dial and the pad for the screen. We have the different drive modes just here. So press onto this, you'll find Eco. We have Comfort, Sport, Sport Plus, and also the individual drive mode as well. Let's leave it in Comfort for now. Also comes up on the dashboard as you flick between them. If you put the car into reverse, you find the parking sensors on the right-hand side and the reverse camera on the left. We also have the wide angle and then the parking assist. Put it back into park by pressing the button on the end of the stalk just there. But that's all I'm going to show you guys today. If you'd like to find out more, please check out the website. This vehicle comes with a fresh service, fresh MOT, and free nationwide next day delivery. Thank you for watching. Video test drive of this Mercedes-Benz C220d. Now the purpose of this video test drive is to show the vehicle drives as you expect it to. As you can see, enough to flatten the steering wheel to keep it in a straight line, not very enough to the left or to the right hand side, but staying straight and true. Now we do have the multifunctional steering wheel, which has the paddle shifters either side, so if you want to steer the car into manual mode, you can simply just tap while the paddles and it will change gear. We then have the volume button here on the left hand side, speedometer and the cruise control on the right. Digital dashboard as well in front of us, which can show with different displays and different features that you would have seen on the photos and also on the video. Now if you do listen carefully throughout the video and test drive, you'll also notice we'll be free from any unwanted knocks or bangs. We also have the full leather seats throughout the vehicle, really comfortable, could easily do 2-3. We've been 400 miles in this vehicle and still get out feeling fresh. Both front seats are also heated, which is perfect for them cold winter mornings. They're also electrically adjustable, again adding to that comfort level. Now we do have many more features on the interior of the vehicle. We've got the main screen here in the centre, which is currently showing the sat nav, but also has many more features you would have seen on the photos For example, the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. You have the gloss black trim here in the centre, really makes the interior a nice place to be. You've got the dual zone climate control as well for the front passengers, with the R-Score air conditioning, which is perfect for them hot summer days. Now we also have the automatic gearbox, which is really smooth. We also have the different drive modes as well. We are about to take a right hand turn, so we put our right indicator on, we'll slow down, and then we make the right hand turn now onto the industrial park. And I will perform an emergency stop now in 3, 2, and 1. Hard onto the brakes, put the car into reverse, got the reverse camera appear on the screen, put it back into a drive now with no issues whatsoever. And if this video hasn't answered all your questions, then please feel free to get in contact with our sales team, where they can answer all unanswered questions, along with running for some inquiries with you. That's all for me today though. Cheers.